So thanks for being on with us. Let's start with the jobs report. Was it anything in there or a surprise to you? It was nice to see some jobs added. I mean, I'll start with the basics.
Well, the jobs that were added really helped the market move up and make more highs today. It's almost like the market is making brand new all-time highs every single day. Even when we had negative economic news, the market has been rallying. So I expected the market to close this week strong before the long weekend and the holiday. Strong no matter what, even if we had bad data. Because when we have bad data, we rally. When we have good data, we rally. The market just wants to continue moving higher.
So we've seen the highs. You said bad days, good days. You know, we just finished talking to Bill Bailey from the NASDAQ. And he talked about smart money getting in and buying a lot of the sectors, including real estate and seeing housing on the rise. Anything that could sort of put the brakes on this rally?
Definitely. What could put the brakes on the rally is another shutdown. God forbid we would have something like that. They're talking about another COVID variant. I don't know if the administration would actually do something like that. That would be devastating to many of these businesses that really have not gotten their full footing since we reopened last summer. So that would definitely create havoc in the market. And at this point now, I'm not saying that that's likely or that's going to happen at all. And I really hope that that does not happen. But I will say that anything is possible after 2020. So right now, the market's breaking out. A lot of people really had bearish biases that the market was extended and couldn't go higher. You had shorts coming in really in the last few weeks, and they're getting pummeled through and stopped out. That's pushing the market higher, and new money, new buying is pushing the market higher. You're seeing the S&P move higher and break out. You're seeing the QQQs move higher and break out. You're seeing Apple rally today up to 240. You're seeing Amazon rally today. I mean, almost everything that you would think we've been waiting and waiting and waiting to finally go, specifically Apple's one of those ones, Amazon, that's been sidelined for a while, they're finally getting some nice buying momentum into them. So there's been some beautiful bullish moves this week, which is really funny because it's the summer and you think it's slow in the summer, but actually it's been some great trading here in the last month.
Absolutely. Like if you went in May and it went away, you'd miss some of the moves that have been happening here, right? We've had a couple of weeks now of gains. All the major averages are higher now for the second week in a row and hitting records at that. You mentioned Apple, and that is one of your long picks. NVIDIA's on there as well. Tell me about your three picks that you say go long. And what kind of time frame are we looking at? Is this for a few months or a long, hey, hold it for a long time or just gain certain percent?
Well, these are short-term moves right now. We're seeing the rally. We've been seeing the rally for the last few weeks in NVIDIA. And for a few weeks, I still think that's short-term. And NVIDIA potentially, depending on what the next earnings are, could get up to some really crazy numbers like 900. I don't know if it's going to go straight up there, but I really think that that is absolutely in the future for NVIDIA. It could be the next 6 months. It may not be this next earnings season, but it could be between now and the end of the year. As far as Apple goes, remember, that stock has not seen new highs for months. And I don't understand why, but finally now we're getting the buying. And remember, earnings season starts right after the holiday, right after the July 4th holiday, the second week of July. We have bank earnings, and then Apple is at the end of the month. So if you're long Apple now, ride it out. I wouldn't take a new position here because I'd wait till see what happens in 2 weeks with the earnings. But right now, Apple looks like it is going to flirt with the previous highs.
I love it. So as we look at what's going on here, I know on the other side of the coin, and we got some Boeing news today, right? We know that there was an emergency landing with two pilots in Honolulu, an expert landing. They made it out well and healthy and all that. That's good news. But Boeing and Walgreens are two of the names that you think have potential to drop. In this case, you actually are saying short them.
Well, Walgreens has been a short for the last 2 days. It bombed on the earnings that fell $5 just in the last 2 days. So that was a beautiful short move. Could it be lower? Yes. It was hovering around 47 today. It could drop all the way down to 45 or even lower. So if you got that short move, congrats. If not, you could take it down to see if you get another $2 out of it. As far as Boeing, I called it short yesterday and then it tanked today. And I didn't even know there was going to be some accident. But the thing is that still could be lower. I haven't really liked Boeing as a long for more than a year, actually. So many people after the drop-off went long it, and I really don't think that that is a strong long until it gets over 300, and it really never got to that number ever since 2020 since we had COVID. And I really want to watch and see what that does on the earnings too. Potentially that could have a nice move up on the earnings, but right now, for now, I would not be long Boeing. It could fall again before it has a rally. So I think for the short-term period here, between now and the next earnings, I would be short Boeing, if anything at all.